Thank you so much for tuning back into Van News Live, taking a look up in Grand Forks. We are seeing those breezy winds continue as they've already reported gusts up to 31 miles an hour. But here in Fargo, our winds are still slightly calmer. We have gusts, though, still just up there with gusts up to 29 miles an hour, with our temperatures sitting at 78. Now, like I said, up for some of those wind speeds, we have gusts up to 30 in Hatlock, 26 in Langdon, 24 in Thief River. Now, we also continue to have some of these stronger winds in the Southern Valley with areas like Siston and Boatbridge with gusts still up to 23 miles an hour. And these winds are also associated with some cooler air and those cooler temperatures, with 60s in Thief River, 66 in Roseau, and even 68 in Grand Forks and in Langdon. But in the Southern Valley, we're still tracking some of those warmer temperatures. Like I said, 78 here in Fargo, 80 in Alexandria, 83 in Brainerd, and even 81 in Aberdeen. Now, over the next couple hours, we do continue to see these warmer temperatures die down with those winds. Now, we are going to continue to see a few passing of these clouds overnight tonight, but otherwise it's going to be fairly calm. But it's also going to be cooler, and what some might say, a cool, crisp North Dakota morning with some chances of some fog, but also some 40s. We are tracking some 40s for the Northern Valley near Hatlock, Langdon, and Rolla, and even near Harvey, North Dakota. But like I said, we're also tracking some fog for areas stretching along that I-29 corridor and just in the southwestern counties near that Brown and Dickey County. But otherwise, we're going to continue to have that fog and those temperatures, or have that fog disappear, and those temperatures already rise up into those 60s just by lunchtime alone, and even into those 70s for most of us. Some might barely scrape out of those 60s, but it's still going to be on the cooler side tomorrow afternoon, with temperatures still sitting in those 70s, and even throughout the rest of the night, temperatures dip back into those 60s after that sun sets. Now, I did say we did have that chance of some wildfire smoke overnight tonight, and tomorrow morning we get to have another band. It is going to be a lighter band, but still wanted to give you that first alert heads up. Now, it is going to kind of linger, and we really get some of the warmer and that warmer colors, or that heavier wildfire smoke, sitting just to the north of Grand Forks in between Pembina and Kitson County tomorrow night. Now, it does continue to move up as we head throughout the rest of your Sunday morning, but we wanted to give you that heads up as it may affect your lovely temperatures tomorrow afternoon, sitting in those 70s with those mostly cloudy skies. But even as we head into the weekend, that wildfire smoke is going to get pushed away by another chance of some rain showers as we head into your Sunday afternoon and into your Sunday morning, with temperatures still sitting in those 70s after we get out of the weekend, but just in those 80s. Arrive again as we head throughout the rest of the middle of the week with those breezy conditions, with more chances of some rain.
We're getting close to September, but conditions still
mostly still
say summer.
Yes.
All right, thanks, Shelby. A new program is helping inmates prepare for life after prison with some high-tech goals. We'll show you how when we come back.